Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are fine and doing good. So in the last video I have discussed about boron and its compounds. So in that, the first one is boric acid, second one is boron trichloride. Now in this session I am going to discuss about third component of boron, that is borates. Third component of a boron. So now borates are electron deficient compounds. Borates are electron deficient compounds. Hydrides of boron is called hydrides. Hydrides of boron called borates. Borates are classified into two types. First one is borane and hydroborane. Borane's formula is HN plus 4. This HN plus 4, where N equal to number of boron atoms. This formula is BNHN plus 6. Two hydrogens extra in hydroborane. Here only four formula, HN plus 4, HN plus 6. Now, where N equal to number of boron atoms, if N equal to 1, sorry, N equal to 2, starting minimum 2, 2 plus 4, 6, B2, it is 2, that's why the name is diborane. What is the name? Diborane. Number of hydrogens is 6, that's why diborane 6. Right? You need to mention the number of hydrogens at the end of the name. So, borane name is indicated by number of boron atoms. N equal to 3, B3, H7. It is triborane, 7 hydrogens. N equal to 4 plus 4, 8. It means B4H8. Then tetraborane, 8 hydrogens. N equal to 5. B5 plus 4, 9, H9. Pentaborane, 9, number 9. N equal to, for example, 10. 6, 7, 8 are there, I am not writing all. You can 10 and write. B10, 10 plus 4, 14. Then you rest. Decaborane, 14 units. These are all borates. Now, we'll observe hydroborates. Hydroborates, N equal to number of which atoms? Boron atoms. If N equal to 3, starting 3, so B3, 6 plus 3, 9. Yes, B3, H9. Triborane 7 is a borate. Triborane 9 is a hydroborate. That is the difference. Borates and hydroborates are separate. Now, N is equal to 4. B4H10. It is tetraborane. Tetraborane 10s. Tetraborane 8 is borane. Tetraborane 10 is hydroborane. Next, N is equal to 5. B5, 5 plus 6, 11, H11. Pentaborane, 11. 11 hydrogens, 10 hydrogens, 9 hydrogens. N is equal to 6. B6, 6 plus 6, H12. It is hexaborane. Hexaborane. Number of hydrogens 12. So similarly 7, 8, 9, I'm writing 10, last one 10. B10, 10 plus 6, 16. That is equal to decaborane. Decaborane 16 is. If number of hydrogen atoms are little more, that indicates hydroborane. Otherwise, that indicates borane. Among all these boranes and hydroboranes, in our syllabus, the given example is only diborane. The first one, N equal to 2, B2 has 6, diborane 6, and it is belongs to borane. So, this is only given in the syllabus. We'll discuss the preparations, properties, structure of diborane. Yes. Now, diborane. So the formula is B2S6. First of all, preparation. Preparations of diborane. 2 moles of boron trifluoride. Treated with 3 moles of LiAlH4, lithium aluminium hydride, then give residue. It will be B2S6, 3 Li and F plus 3 Al, AlF3. So this will be 3. Right? So 4BF3, to balance this, we need to take 4, it is 2B2S6, right? Diborane is prepared from boron trifluoride and lithium aluminium hydride. Second preparation is industrial scale. It is first one, second one, on industrial scale. It means large scale preparation of diborane. So by 2BF3, 2BF3 plus 6LiH lithium hydride, then give rise to B2S6 plus 6 moles of Li and 6 moles of fluorine removed as a 6LiF. Next, laboratory method. Third one is laboratory method. Convenient laboratory method. Laboratory method means on small scale. 2NaDH4 sodium borohydride, like lithium aluminium hydride, treated with I2 iodine, then give rise to 2NaI plus B2S6 plus 6 means hydrogen gas left. It is diborane will be formed on laboratory method or a small scale. Not only by this, a few more also. 2BCl3 plus 6H2 gives rise to 2B2H6 plus 2B2H6 plus 6HCl. Otherwise, 6HCl. It is only 1 6HCl extra. Copper aluminium combination acting as a catalyst in this process. Next, 2BF3 plus 6NaH. 2BF3 plus 6NaH. I think it is similar to this one. LiH is replaced by NaH. B2H6 plus 6NaF. B2H6 plus 6NaF. These are all preparations of, what are the preparations of diborate? Physical and chemical properties of diborate. Physical properties of diborate. So, physical properties of diborate. Diborate is colorless, colorless, toxic gas, toxic, colorless, highly toxic gases. Boiling point of diborate is, boiling point is 180 kelvins. So it can catch fire readily or spontaneously when exposed to air. It can catch fire readily or spontaneously when exposure to air. When exposure to air. So air contains moisture, it means water or oxygen, then give rise. B2H6 plus 3O2 give rise. So B2O3 plus 3H2. Delta H equal to, the value of delta H is minus 1976 kilojoule per minus 1976 kilojoule per right. Minus means exothermic. Heat is liberated. That's why it catches fire readily by the heat liberation when exposure to air on treatment with oxygen. So, not only borane, even higher boranes also easily flammable in air. Higher boranes also spontaneously flammable when exposed to air. Higher boranes also can catch fire, spontaneously flammable in air. Spontaneously flammable in air. When reacts with which one? Oxygen, they can fire easily. And in absence of moisture, in absence of moisture, it means H2O. Diborane is stable. Diborane is stable. If in presence of moisture, diborane is unstable. But in presence of moisture, diborane is unstable. Diborane is unstable because it can react with the moisture, then forms B2H6 plus 3H2O give rise to The product is 2H3BO3. 2H3BO3 plus 6H. Boric acid will be formed in presence of moisture. That's why it is less reactive. Next. After this, chemical properties we will discuss. Chemical properties of iron. Chemical properties of diboric. So first one, reaction with metal hydride. Reaction with metal hydride. Metal hydride. The formula will be NH, where M equal to sodium, lithium, etc. It means lithium hydride, sodium hydride treated with the diboron, then what will be formed. So now reaction will be 2 moles of NH plus B2S6 gives us 2MBH4. It is plus, it is minus. Metal borohydride. Metal borohydride will be formed. These are acting as reducing agents. Example, taking now 2LiH plus B2S6. Lithium hydride, metal is a lithium hydride. 2LiBH4. BH4. Lithium borohydride. Sodium, if you take sodium borohydride, those are all acting as which agents? Reducing agents. Next, treated with ammonia. Reaction with ammonia. Reaction with ammonia. B2H6 plus 6NH3 gives rise to BH2 NH3 thrice. So 2BH2 NH3 twice. So bracket close. Then the another compound is BH4 minus. It is plus BH4 minus. Both are aside. This one and this one cation and anion. This is on further heating. Then give rise to B3N3H6 2 moles plus 12 moles of hydrogen gas will be 2 are there. So B3N3H6 plus NH3 twice, it is 3 moles actually. B3N3H6, it is called very important, it is. Yes, borazole, borazine, also called inorganic benzene. Inorganic benzene. Inorganic benzene means it is just like as a benzene structure without carbons and hydrogens. That's why it is called inorganic benzene. Now the structure of inorganic benzene is very, very important. We have to study it. Yes, B3N3H6 structure inorganic benzene. So there are boron, nitrogen, boron, nitrogen. On each and every atom, there is one hydrogen. Okay, B3N3H6. So nitrogen is a 15th group element, totally 5 valence electrons are there, but here only 1, 2, 3, two more are there, lone pair. Lone pair on each and every nitrogen. You might have to mention the lone pair on nitrogen, right? Boron is a 3rd group element, 13th group element, only 3 valence electrons, 1, 2, 3 involved in boron. Now, these electrons can shift here, these can shift here, and these can shift here. On shifting electrons, the structure will be, so I am drawing like this, structure is boron, nitrogen, boron, nitrogen, boron, nitrogen. So there is a double bond formation, double bond formation, double bond formation by these two electrons. On each and every atom, hydrogen is there. Hydrogen. Okay? And afterwards, in a reverse way also you can take this structure. The structure will be double bond here, obviously, the position will be shifted, double bond position shifted. Boron, nitrogen, boron, nitrogen, boron, nitrogen. On each and every atom there is hydrogen. Hydrogen. Okay? So this is the structure of which one? Borazine. Now, actually nitrogen is losing electron, boron is gaining electron. Then you can take nitrogen is plus, boron is minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. You can take like that also. Nitrogen losing electrons, that's why plus, boron gaining electrons, minus. So, in this structure, boron hydrogen bond is 120 picometers. Boron hydrogen bond length is 120 picometers. Nitrogen hydrogen bond length is, nitrogen and hydrogen bond length is 102 picometers. 102 picometers. Next, boron nitrogen bond length will be, boron nitrogen bond length will be 144 picometers. 144 picometers. These three lengths are very very. It is nitrogen boron or boron nitrogen, both are correct. So the bond lengths are very very important. It will be varied because of the electronegativity difference. This is reaction with ammonia, then forms a borazine. Next, diborans can react with Lewis bases, then forms an addition product. Diborane reacts with Lewis bases, then gives an adduct. Adduct meaning is addition product. So now, for example, B2H6 plus COO or MME trice. ME means methyl group, formula is CH3. ME is CH3, how many times that is? 3 times, CH3 trice. Then we have 2BH3 NME trice. 2BH3 means B2H6, B2H6. And NME3 adds. NME3 is added addition product. B2H6 plus, another example is 2CO, 2CO, it is a carbonyl group, capital C, capital O, then give us 2BH3CO, addition product. Similarly, diborane can react with halogens, then gives diborane can reacts with halogens, Now, B2H6 plus 6Cl2 gives rise to 2BCl3 plus 6HCl. Boron trichloride will be formed. B2H6 plus Br2, only one mole I have taken. So one hydrogen is replaced by one bromine. Then B2H6 modified as a H5. In place of 6 hydrogen, bromine will be added. The rest of the hydrogen and bromine will be eliminated as a HCl. Similarly, with a base, B2H6 plus KOH plus H2O give rise to 2 moles of KOH I am taking, plus 2H2O. 2KBO2 plus 6H2, it is 6H2, right? It is potassium metaborate. In the last video, we have discussed 2NaBO2, that is sodium metaborate, which is obtained from borax, which is used as a borax bead test. We have studied already. And now, observe carefully in these examples, especially. B2H6, you can write it as BH3BH3. Okay. So, boron, third group element, 3 valency electrons, 13 group elements, 1, 2, 3. Totally 3 hydrogens are there. On each hydrogen, one electron is available. 1s1 configuration. These two involved in bond. Right now? Totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons. Incomplete octet. To complete its octet, they will accept electrons, then Lewis acids. To complete their octet, they will accept an electron pair, then act as Lewis acids. Lewis acids are electron acceptors. BH3 is only 6 electron deficient. Why it is electron deficient? It is BH3, it is also BH3. So BH3 is a monomer, B2H6 is a dimer. B2H6 is divided into BH3. Each BH3 is electron deficient, only 6 electrons around the boron, incomplete octet. To complete its octet, it will accept an electron pair because it is an electron deficient compound, then it is acting as Lewis acid. Clear? Diboron is electron deficient compound due to its incomplete octet, hence it will accept an electron from others, that's why diboron is Lewis acid. Right. Next. Structure of diboron. It is important. First of all, formula is B2H6 or BH3. Otherwise, 2BH3 also you can write. This is the structure of diboron. Now, central atom in diboron is boron. 2 borons are. Central atom configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. This is the last shell, 2s2, 2p1. S contains 2 electrons, p contains only 1 electron. 2, 1. In the first excited state, it will shift it to 2p. Then the configuration is, yes, 1, 2, 3. Actually, 2s, 2p. totally sp3 hybridization. Among that, observe carefully, 1, 2, 3 are half-filled sp3 hybrid orbitals, one is empty hybrid orbital. Yes, boron, it is boron, it is also boron. Each boron atom undergoes sp3 hybridization, then forms 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, 1s and 3p, then gives 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. Among 4, 1, 2, 3 are half-filled sp3 hybrid orbitals and 1 is empty sp3 hybrid orbital. Now, first one, so better you take the big diagram. Yes, it is sp3, sp3, sp3. All are sp3 hybrid orbitals. It is half-filled, half-filled. It is empty, very, very important. It is also half-filled. 3 are half-filled, 1 is empty. Similarly, another boron. Also undergoes same sp3 hybridization, central atom boron configuration 2s2 2p1. So one electron jumps in another boron also, same it will happen. So 3 are half filled, 1 is empty sp3 hybrid orbital. So now it is sp3, 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. Among them, 3 are half-filled sp3 hybrid orbitals, one is empty sp3 hybrid orbitals. Now, hydrogens are, hydrogen configuration is 1s1, hydrogen configuration is 1s1, 1s, s orbital shape is a spherical shape. So, first hydrogen, 1s1 means, 1s1 means one electron. Second hydrogen, 1s, one electron. Third hydrogen, 1s, one electron. Fourth hydrogen, 1s, one electron. So one will be upside, other one will be downside, spin. And fifth hydrogen, 1s1. Sixth hydrogen, 1s. Clear all of it? Very, very important. Observe carefully. 6 hydrogens, the structure will be, you can take boron, boron. So now, these two are overlap, finally you will get, yes, it is just like as banana. And this is a bond, single bond, it is also single bond, it is also single bond, it is also single bond. There is a hydrogen. This is just like as a banana type, that's why called banana bond or tau bond. Banana bond or tau bond. And the description is, in diborane B2H6, each boron undergoes sp3 hybridization, 3 empty orbitals of sp3 and 3 half-filled sp3 hybrid orbitals and 1 empty sp3 hybrid orbital around the boron, totally 4. 3 are half-filled sp3 and 1 is empty sp3 hybrid orbitals. So now, sp3 empty hybrid orbital of boron, 1s, 1 orbital of hydrogen and half-filled sp3 hybrid orbital of another boron overlap with each other, then forms a banana. Now, BHB, these hydrogens are terminal hydrogens and these two hydrogens are bridged hydrogens. Now, observe carefully, 1, 2, 3, 4, hydrogen atoms. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 are 1, 2, 3, 4 are terminal hydrogens. Terminal hydrogens. There are four terminal BH bonds. Terminal BH. 1, 2, 3, 4 terminal BH bonds. Next, it is 5. It is 6. 5 and 6 hydrogens are bridged hydrogens. Which hydrogens? Bridged hydrogens. Yes. BHB. BHB. There are 2 BHB bridges. 2 BHB bridged bonds are there in diborane. Now observe carefully. BH bond. 1 electron, 1 electron. 2 electrons. Hydrogen, boron, 2 centers. Boron, hydrogen, 2 centers. 1 electron, 1 electron, 2 electrons. Boron, hydrogen, 2 centers. 1, 2 electrons. Boron, hydrogen, 2 centers. 1, 2 electrons. It means terminal bonds are, these are 2 centered, 2 electron bonds. Terminal BH bonds are 2 centered, 2 electron bonds. 2 centered BH and electron of boron and electron of hydrogen. 2 centered, 2 electron bonds. Bridged are 1 boron, bridged hydrogen, 2nd boron, 3rd. BHB bridge, totally 3 centers. BHB, 3 centers. 1, 2, and this is empty. It means 2 electrons, 3 centers. 2 electrons, 3 centers. Got it? Those are bridged. Bridged bonds are. Bridged bonds are. Right there. 2 bridged bonds are. 3 centered. 3 centered. 2 electron bond. Because it is electron deficient compound. 2 BHB bonds are bridged bonds. Those are 3 centered BHB. 2 electrons from, one is boron, another one is hydrogen, and another boron will be empty. So the terms 2 centered 3 electron bond, sorry, 2 centered 2 electron bonds are terminal bonds. 4 BH bridges, 2 centered 2 electron bonds, 4, those are 4 terminal BH bonds. So 3 centered 2 electron bonds, there are 2 BHB bridges, so bridged bonds. Clear? Now how the arrangement is handled? Boron, boron. It is a plane. So on the plane, total hydrogen. On the plane, 2 borons and 4 hydrogens. On a plane, 2 boron atoms and 4 hydrogens, total 6 atoms on the plane. So remaining 2, one is above the plane, another one is below the plane. It is below the plane and it is above the plane, and remaining all are on the, which one that is in plane. Clear, all of it. And the bond lengths are very, very important. Take down the bond lengths also. 97 degrees, 134 picometers. 97 degrees. And this length will be 134 picometers. BH bond length will be. And the terminal BH bond length will be 119 picometers. It is 119 picometers. 119 picometers. Next. And the angle will be 120 degrees. This angle will be 120 degrees. So here I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, same number in aluminium. 1, 1 2 3 4 R. 1 2 3 4 are terminal hydrogens. Then from 4 terminal BH bonds, terminal angle will be 120 and terminal BH bond length will be 119 picometers. Similarly, it is 5 and 6. 5 6 are bridged hydrogens. There are 2 BHB bridges, BHB bonds. The BH bridged length will be 134 picometers and the angle will be 97 degrees. You have to remember all this. And with this, boron and its compounds completed. So better you study the uses of aluminium and boron also. So theoretical points only, no need to write all the points on the board. Just verify your textbook. So in our next class, we will discuss lipids.